getting some adult entertainment, thank you.
Well, I've already told you what it's about, y'all just...
Well, I'm gathered from what I've received from the owner, Ms. Ruby, as well as a lot of others. You know where y'all be going there. The deal is peaches.
Oh, God, I've been here before.
No, this is something different. And so my thing was, my thing is, the brain before the commission, because the fact is, once again, you know where y'all be getting there. That their complaint is that they have band-aids on their period. And so, you know, and I can... That's why I called Paige that problem.
You know, I won't excuse yourself.
And then I'm okay for excuses, but that's the only portion that is being covered, to my understanding. And it was between the airman and the owner, they can see a difference if you know where you are.
I'm going to walk control of the retreat.
I mean, the airman is all over the world. Of course, in both places, you can go to different other cities, and I'm saying you just got a bad day. On that portion, just wanted to know if that's something to relax.
You handled that real well, Marcus.
Do we have those places?
Yeah. Yes, we do. But they had band-aids on. And it ran across.
Let me kind of clear this up. I think the Commissioner Marshall is asking, should we revisit the adult entertainment ordinance in regards to passes? Can I make that?
That's
all the other.
I mean, you got everything. That's the problem.
How many of these outfits are in the tank?
I have none. But they even talk about the Bemiss. We're outside the road, but I know this movie.
We got mail roof on this building. Not like it comes through.
Between Ms. Ruby and all the airmen, I don't want to get in paper about the airmen. That's really where that's the majority of the crowd that goes there. From
what kind of crowd?
Military crowd that tend to go there. She says about 80% of her customers.
Is that the features you're talking about?
But. You know, I would just ask this question of you. You've had the conversation with the proprietor of that business, is that right? With a change in that ordinance, would it change their business in?
Can't it feel it will? I mean, I guess.
I'm not sure that it would. I mean, that again. I mean, kind of.
I don't know if the objective is even to change the businesses. Is to make it customary at all. Or, I guess, in, you know. Whew. If anybody that goes from one, that's what you do.
But isn't that a line of delineation, so to speak, between two sets of walls or something? I mean, because then you go from being a one type to a new establishment, right?
I mean, there's a difference, I think, between, that's where you cross the line to nudity, if I understand it.
Not to read it very often. have lawful, but
I was getting on how somebody put in the zoning to get, they was trying to open up a establishment.
It was the same establishment we've been talking about, and they were trying to take it over.
Well, to my knowledge, we had two establishments at one time, and now we're down to one. Is that Paradise? We had Paradise and now, and Peaches. Paradise is a thing for the history books.
Days of Food wanted to, but whoever bought them or was going to be.
Really?
Yeah, that's what that was.
I don't know. Sorry, Rick, Casey. You throw it out there.
I don't see why we need it at all.
You know, it is a question that deserves discussion in reality, because I'm going back to the same thing that I said earlier. There's that line that you need to try to decide where you want to be at from your population's quality of life, but to some, that's what it is. Some folks, their quality of life is totally different from the quality of life of another group of citizens. Some of them look for that adult entertainment and that evening, the night, you know, how they spend their recreation idea, how that is done, whether or not that's done in that type of environment, or whether their quality of life and what they see is in another situation. That is a huge question. Now, I will tell you this, Mr. Parsons, again, this is just Bill's opinion. We're still deep into the Bible Belt. We still live in a very, very morally sound and based society and community. My thoughts on that would be is that you can change the ordinance and do what you want to do, but you would have pushback from the community when you start down that road, and that's just my opinion. If you're willing to tackle that, that's a decision that, again, that we'll have to make if we want to go down that road. If you had the desire to have those type of entertainments, if the owner of Peaches was coming to the commissioners and saying, it's standing room only, they're standing up down the sidewalk, down the side of Bemiss Road trying to get into my facility, you would have other proprietors that would be ready to open up an establishment. So you have to look at it again from the standpoint of economics. If that need was there, we would be hearing more from the citizens. We would be hearing more from entrepreneurs that would want to be opening up those establishments. We'd have more applications for that type of business than what we're currently seeing. And those applications would be based on the current regulations that we have. I haven't seen that. Now, again, I'm that guy that's not out at 10 o'clock in a bar somewhere, so I don't go by Peaches to see what the crowd looks like on a Friday or Saturday evening. So I can't give you that information. I don't know. But I do know that, again, economics drives a lot of entrepreneurs to make decisions for them to do what they decide to do. And if that establishment was busting at the seams, either that individual or another individual would be looking to open up another establishment. I haven't seen that. And I would ask if there's even been any inquiries from a licensing standpoint for that type of establishment.
Not that I'm aware of.
That's just my, you know, where I'm at with it. So I don't think changing the ordinance just to change the ordinance because that establishment and that one small group of the population would like to see that take place, if that be the case, that doesn't really warrant enough for I feel like the commissioners to say, we have a need to change this ordinance. Again, if we were being hammered, if they were being hammered for requests for those new establishments, and that wasn't growing, you might want to look at, as some communities have, a designated area where you're going to have that type of establishment. I don't really think that if you ask anybody at our military installation or at BSU, is that they probably would never tell you that one of the things we're missing in our community are more adult entertainment locations. That's not on their radar. That's not what they're looking for. I think what they're looking for.
The question was posed, could they be like adult entertainment?
Others like where? Atlanta? I mean,
Savannah, Jacksonville, different other places.
Got it.
That was the question that was posed.
Yeah. So, in other words, can you remove the restrictions that you currently have on the adult entertainment establishments? That would be what you're saying.
Here,
that's what I'm saying. Remove the restrictions.
And I guess that one restriction is the basis.
That's right.
What would the citizens' response be? If the people who elected you, what would they
I looked at it as a business, asked a question, I didn't have the answer. It's not for me to give you an answer. It's right before the commission to see what their response would be.
Well, I commend you for bringing it up. I mean, it takes courage to do that to start with, just to say, hey, this is an issue I need to address. I've had a constituent that asked me. I mean, and that's great. I just don't feel like, I mean, this again, this is Bill's opinion now, and I'm not even saying this is the opinion of the chairman. This is just my own personal opinion. Unless there was a real push and a request for more adult entertainment establishments, there may be a need to consider that. But the folks that's going to Peaches aren't making a decision on that evening, whether do I go to Peaches or do I go to Jackson. They're going to Peaches. And they're going there because, as the current ordinance states, they can sell alcohol and they can see as much of the flesh as they want to see. Or not as much as they want to see, but as much as the ordinance allows them to see.
Which they can't see.
That's just Bill's spot.
I
didn't
know my hands.
Animal services, the next.
Yeah. Thank you.